Hello friends, today in this video we are going to learn about lyophilizer. So do subscribe to our channel for pharma related information and pharma knowledge. So coming to today's thing, the principle involved in the lyophilizer is freeze drying or cryodesiccation, or also known as lyophilization, which is a low temperature dehydration which generally involves freezing the product and lowering the pressure, then removing ice by sublimation. So here you can see the steps in clear and detail. First step is freezing the product, lowering the pressure, then sublimation, which is generally known as converting the solid to vapor without converting into liquid, then removing the ice. So dry powder is formed. So here you can see the diagram of a lyophilizer or image and the triple point of water. Here is important note is during the process of lyophilization, the pressure inside the freeze dryer must be below the triple point value and sample temperature must be below the freezing point. So steps in freeze drying: pre-freezing, then primary drying, then secondary drying. So these are the three steps involved. We will know in detail about every step. Let us start with the freeze drying, and that is pre-freezing, which is an important step. During this process, the sample will get frozen, that is slow phase transition, which results in large ice crystals. That is, the liquid to solid transition will take place slowly, that is made to take place slowly in a controlled manner, so that large ice crystals can be formed, which can be easily lyophilized during the process. So this is the importance of pre-freezing. Then primary drying, which is the second step of lyophilization. The sublimation starts here, that is conversion of solid ice to vapor will take place without conversion into liquid, and the energy for the process is given by gentle heating of the sample where sublimation starts and we can produce a dry sample. So primary drying is an important step in lyophilization or freeze drying. So one must remember the every point in primary drying, which gives additional importance to it. And coming to the next step involved is secondary drying. Here the residual water in this step it can be removed, that is the extra water which may be present, which may be left unremoved during the primary drying, is removed during secondary drying by lowering the pressure and increasing the temperature. So let us see the advantages. We know freeze-dried products are highly stable and easy to reconstitute, and they can be stored for longer periods because they are in solid form. If the product is in liquid, we can face stability issues. So here we can less stability issues will be there. And coming to the limitations, that is expensive, that is the lyophilizer is expensive with some stability issues. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to our channel for this kind of information.